It's review time, but let me disembark first. Headgear 1, setup mode, start record. Headgear 1, change optic to hunter mode. I like that voice control, so let's try the Vendul scanner. Headgear 1, Vendul scanner mode. This thing is a multimedia tool, so I like 2944. Anyway, let's come to the review. Headgear 1. Change to YouTube. Search the video Star Citizen, The Next Great Starship, Episode 11. Broadcast on random screens. Start video.
Five teams we're going to watch today, but only two can make it through to the next round. So you guys are going to have tough choices in the voting.
Yeah, be super tough.
Well, not pleasant.
So are we ready to check out the first team?
Yes.
Sounds good.
Let's do it.
Team Talon Corp.
Hello, Star Citizens. I'm just going to be giving you a brief update as to some of the changes that have happened with the ship since the last update. I've actually taken the liberty to print off the Mark 1.
Oh my god.
So it should help with showing some of the changes where it's happened and stuff like that, so that you can get a better idea of what's actually happened. And some of the main things that have happened are with the Class 5 guns, so the top and the bottom gun have been changed now, so that there's much more firepower delivered from these weapons. So there's actually it's a dual mount on both of them, so there's actually four cannons in each. The front cannon as well. So these are two cannons now, but that's retractable. Obviously that's not in this model because this is the older variant that you've seen in the other videos, but that's now retractable. You'll see that in some of the shots and possibly in animation in a minute. Also the engine mounts are different now, so these are the old style engine mounts. The new ones are much more in line with the overall look, the curved sort of look of the body. And they actually have an additional function whereby when this ship is coming into the atmosphere, you know, to avoid debris going into the engines and ruining them. Basically they compress and another flap opens up and basically makes the line continuous across that, so all the heat and all the debris and stuff like that have come in through the upper atmosphere is deflected. The cockpit, I mean, you can see here, a couple of people have highlighted the fact that like the cockpit doesn't necessarily have good visibility. I'll show you some images of how it looks in game as well. You can actually, it's quite a big field view actually. The seat is directly underneath this top heat shield, so basically you're looking like out and across and down and up as well. I've got quite a lot of visibility in the front area there. I don't know if you can see the actual seat in the inside there, but that's where it is anyway. The drop pods, you'll see there's been quite a lot of changes, so obviously not on this one, but this has got the old military spacefaring drop pod. The reason why it isn't necessarily in keeping with the aesthetics of this ship is because it is modular, so it would be able to fit onto a number of different ships, including this one. There's also the bat unit has made a return, and a number of other smaller craft that would be able to fit into this just to make the package a lot more worthwhile. So yeah, the rocket pods have also changed since this iteration, so these ones were placeholders, but there's a new variation now. And, yeah, so generally I've just been working on texturing and in-game implementation, and hopefully by the end of this video you'll be able to see that I've got it in-game. And other than that, I've just been working on different variations on texturing, which I put up on the forum the other day to see if people were particularly interested in know, Spec Ops or, you know, pirate sort of overlay. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen, and Talon Corp signing out. I'll see you in the verse.
Yeah, the Shadow Mantis is a very impressive ship. I like the design from the beginning. I like his ideas, what he had at the beginning. And what he did in the competition is very impressive. The modularity of the ship is awesome. He thinks different, he thinks tactical, and I like it because I'm playing Arma since the beginning and Operation Flashpoint since 2000. The cockpit area is not everybody's darling. I like it because you have a lot of sensors in your ship and you have eyes around you. You don't have to look straight at obstacles. It's definitely not the best dogfight cockpit, I think. But let's see. Maybe it's better than I expect. Yeah, this ship is more than an ordinary gunship. So this is specialized for special operations, and the body, like a bullet, looks easy to fabricate on a mass fabrication system line. So this is good.
So the next video is Infinite Shoe Monkey. Let's roll it.
Hello, fellow citizens. We would like to show you our result of the mounting stage.
Here you can see the rear cargo ramp that we implemented into the model. It features different modes for loading and unloading cargo more easily, as well as giving protection to the marines when deployed, or allowing some quick access in this mode. Also, it includes a ramp to access the rear seat for the Class 5 turret more easily. Here you can see the cargo area with more detail, as well as the new boarding turret. And in the crew habitat, we of course added more detail as well. The meeting table got an additional feature now, because it's got the medical surgery robot. And in the background, you can see the escape pods / sleeping pods. Here you can see the rear cockpit seats for the gunners when they are not in action, and the front pilot seat with the detailed console. This is the front access area of the ship, including the missile revolvers to the left and the right, and the front docking collar area. Also, here is the access point for the front Class 5 turret with an additional airlock. Here you can see the overall layout of the ship with all its detail and an additional area that you should find out in the game. We've made sure that all the detail actually fits into our hull, just like for the internals that you already saw in some previous renderings. The rear turret deployment has been added as well. The front turret has been reworked and the front docking collar has now got some hatches to cover it. The rear docking collars as well, the upper one as well as the lower one. The missile revolver's got its hatches as well. And here is the front access to the ship for the crew, and the revised landing gear. Finally, you can see the atmospheric stabilizers in action, and a first person access to the Class 5 turret. This is the front Class 5 turret, by the way. Finally, we added some renderings for you with the current materials, which we'll work on further in the next stage with the CryEngine implementation.
The Monkey Station is a very, very beautiful animated ship. It's definitely not a gunship. It's more like a support ship, medical-wise or ammunition-wise or whatever. But this is more a social ship. I like the interior and the feeling inside of the ship. It's very comfortable. I like it. I like it very much. This ship is on my favorite list on the place 3 or 4. But in this competition, remember, we search a gunship. And the size of this ship here, the Monkey Station, is definitely too big for a gunship. But a very good support ship, social ship, supply ship, it's a station. Yeah, very, very good ship, animation, interior, good points. The turrets are impressive and very well animated. I don't like the rotation of the hatchway. The rest is okay. The rocket revolvers are very, very impressive. I like that. I like the design. I like the integration in the hull. Very nice. Yeah, what I don't like is the look of the stabilizers. I don't like it from the look. It's too big parts for me. But anyway, a very good ship. Next is Try.
We're going to just jump right in and show you what we got. Early on, we're going to show you some pieces. These are just pieces and parts, little kit that we have to go around the ship. There's a full upstairs interior shot, and that is the escape pod there that you can see. This is the interior of the turret and also the exterior body. There's some other older shots that we had here that we just wanted to revamp and show you a little bit more of. And there's a paint over we did for the silverback. This is more interior with a little more exterior texture on there that we were playing with. And you can see we've done quite a bit on the interior as far as detailing more. And that's a nice little seat animation that 3D Vice did. Thanks for that. We have several areas in here, a little sink and whatnot. This is some more texturing work. And our Rebel Alliance paint scheme. And this is some actual in-engine footage. Thanks to Griffin for putting this together. We've actually gotten pretty far with some of the engine work as far as getting things in there. So we're really putting a lot of our focus on detailing all the little parts of the modeling, just getting that fine detail in place, and also working out some of the texture. The texturing is obviously something that you got to get right. You don't want to just throw it together. So we're spending a lot of time there and working out those fine details with the texture. These are some paint schemes that we did. Just to give you a couple of options, one more of the military Desert Storm type look, and the other one is probably what you might see with the civilian variant, people who want something a little more flashy. As you see, we put some old stripes and checkerboards on there, like from World War II planes. So we hope you like what you see, guys. Give us your feedback on the forums, and hey, we'll see you in a verse. Peace.
Try ship looks to me more than a cutlass on steroid, and is for me personally more a pirate ship, and a beautiful pirate ship. If I were a pirate and had a pirate career, and I would chose definitely the steroid cutlass, the Silverback. I like that name. It's a cool name. It's a cool ship. So we will see when and what's happened with the ship in the future after the competition. And really, I hope all the competition ships will be flyable in the verse. The big bad verse. The big bad verse. The big bad verse.
All right, so Team Cryo's next. Let's roll the video.
Greetings, citizens. Fuzzy Modem here. It's springtime in Alaska, and I get to show you how I beat cabin fever this year, so I'm not going to waste another second.
The RSI Polaris gunship is a modular weapons platform that can be outfitted with a variety of catamaran hulls by aftermarket manufacturers. The most popular is a piracy interdiction and civilian escort Paladin variant by Sakura Sun, featuring a munitions pod and armor plating. The armor is a direct response to the ramming tactic of Vandal Sith fighters, as their blades pass through energy shields, inflicting heavy damage to unarmored hull. The Sakura Sun X99 rampart is designed to deflect and even damage the Vandal if they attempt to ram. Built in cooperation with RSI from the scraps of Bengal carrier engine heat shield fabrication, the armor is also an effective defense against all thermal attacks. A redundant energy shield generator provides yet another layer of protection to the port side. The Sakura Sun D10 munitions pod features a powerful sensor suite and houses missiles, countermeasures, and proximity mines safely away from the primary hull. This combination of elements makes for a unique combat tactic known as the sword and shield maneuver. When attacking, the gunship pilot will charge and empty their missile rack, depleting an opponent's energy shields. The pilot will then toggle from fly-by-wire to Newtonian and drift, thrusting occasionally to keep the shield between themselves and the enemy, while bringing all three turrets to bear. The pilot seat extends forward, providing wide visibility, but when both energy shields are down, armor plates extend to protect the cockpit. Hover cycle-style gunnery seats provide optimum broadside line of sight. Turrets are designed to accommodate all Class 1 Size 3 weapons and also serve as airlocks and lifeboats. The cockpit is sealed as well, meaning that, if necessary, the cargo ramp can be opened in vacuum, allowing for easy retrieval of EVA personnel. Passengers are typically restricted to the cargo hold, which seats 6. The upper deck leads to both dorsal and ventral turrets. When the ramp is closed, it offers a second route from the upper deck down to the cargo hold. Unlike the RSI civilian vessels Aurora and Constellation, the Polaris is a military ship, and the interior design reflects this, with functionality and reliability prioritized over comfort. Thrusters are positioned for exceptional roll speed in order to best bring a broadside to bear, and during VTOL, all four rear thrusters support the forward ventral thrusters. With aftermarket manufacturers introducing catamaran upgrades to suit every application, the potential of the Polaris gunship seems unlimited, provided you have the credits.
Sean Tracy, what did you think of that?
I love the asymmetry of the ship, this catamaran extensions. That's really cool to make it modular like that. And I really do like that Paladin variant. I'm a bit of a fantasy game guy, and I like the fact that it looks like a sword and shield, something like this.
Overall, like, I think maybe style-wise, like, and you know, the texturing on the outside, you know, needs some work. I don't know how far he's gotten, if it's work in progress still, but it looked a little like concrete on the outside and texture because it was real bumpy and gray. Looks-wise, you know, it's not like the best-looking ship, perhaps, but like it has so much functionality and like the interior is so cool, like it makes up for that. I'm actually pretty impressed by what he did.
All right, Chris O.
I'm impressed with the overall shape. It's an interesting ship. I think it's an ugly ship, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. I think some of the pieces on the different sort of like variants he had, I think. It seems too cluttery. It doesn't have sort of an elegant feel. Or from a sort of a design standpoint, it seemed like just a lot of like tacked on things and a lot of busyness. And what is it that you call it?
The different
high frequency?
Reads.
Frequency.
Oh, high frequency, yeah. Where you have the different reads that go up and then the frequency changes.
It all seems very constant, just pieces, right. You know, chunk pieces.
Yeah, you want to have like dense and then rest and then like dense.
Well, like he had like the shapes, like, so even the extensions, like you have this big main shape, and then right. the outside appendages were almost the same size.
Yeah.
I mean, even that shield, it looked huge compared to the ship almost, like it was competing.
I'm following this, Sean, you're looking lost.
No, I'm following.
You want to watch it again?
It was super asymmetrical. I don't know how you saw the same thing on either side.
I'm talking about volume of shapes.
Oh, sure, okay.
Not the model itself.
Okay.
Just the weight of it.
And I also think, like, we talk a lot about the visual appeal of all the ships, and that's obviously a big part of it, but this is actually the first ship that he's talked a lot about the gameplay, like how you actually pilot this thing, and that's one of the biggest things with it. Like, you might want to buy a ship that's going to look really nice, but the other thing, you're going to want to buy a ship that's really fun to play with, and that seems like something that's going to be a lot of fun for me.
But let's roll the last video, Skyguard Fabrications.
So here we've got a 3/4 view of the ship with basic tones laid down on top of it. This is to help me determine what the balance of the ship would be with all of its textures and all the colors and things like that laid on top of it. You can see there's quite a bit of geometry on the surface detailing of the ship. All of this would be geometry that would be in the game. So this is all sort of, this is the low poly version of the ship that would be thrown directly into the game. We've got some turntables here just to show you a better view of what the ship looks like from all angles. In addition to here, you can see what the ship looks like with both the man turrets and the main front turret deployed, as well as the missiles deployed. Here you can also see pretty clearly what the geometry is like. I spent a lot of time making sure that it was very clean, very smooth. And the final poly count for the exterior of the ship comes
the same
close to 400,000 poly. It's a lot of polys, but I think it's it shows in some of the geometry. You can see here at the base of the turret, there's a lot of geometry going on there. I've got the missile deployment animation. Turret deployment animation, which is one of my favorites. I actually really like how the panels sort of collapse onto themselves and then fold into the ship as the turret comes out. Then I've also got a very quick block out of what the interior would be like. You can see loading rails on the ground for when you're loading cargo.
The modeling was really clean. The animations are amazing. I mean, you know, the animation he did on the Sakura Sun gun was
that
great.
That was cool.
Yeah, it was cool too.
So animation's really great. Yeah, I mean, it's sort of hard. Like, if I was going to have to pick some of them, this sort of feels like it's not as far along. So, like, what's the interior? How do you move around in it?
Mm-hmm.
That's an issue. And then I do agree that there is a certain, like, when you look at some of the views, like the rear view looking at the engines, it did kind of feel like what a model, like an expensive G.I. Joe model would look like. and I don't know whether that's just because of perhaps some of the proportions of the pieces, but you know, I think also, like, Skyguard style, like, he's got a very sort of graphic style, like he did in his concept.
Which is cool, right? Yeah.
Which is cool when you're going for sort of a more stylized graphic stuff.
Next year one, defensive smoke.
You know the deal? 5 teams we're going to see today, but only 2 can go through to the next round. 3 will go into the safe pool. Are you guys ready? How are we feeling?
Let's do it.
Yeah, let's see some cool
I'm
shit.
Excited.
It's getting difficult.
And the first team we're going to look at is Shard Collective. Mm-hmm. Let's roll the video.
Hello, RSIN community. This is Shard Collective here. We really appreciate all the feedback from judges and fans alike and have done our best to incorporate all the ideas we liked best into our design. At the request of the community, we've all reworked the tail, changed the turrets to be semi-retractable, as well as modified thruster and wing locations to maximize turret fire coverage. This is our final textured model. In the next minute, we're going to show some animation renders that are untextured due to time constraints. In our texturing work, we made a careful effort to emulate the style of existing Origin ships, as well as to give a scale reference. The AX-114 Boomsling will be a sleek, functional, luxurious, and heavy-hitting gunship. Here are some animations demonstrating some ship functionality, such as the front landing gear, the front turret, the main exit elevator, the pilot emergency exit, the rear ramp deployment, the refueling probe, and the front thruster functionality. Here are some images of the ship's interior. And here's the final textured model ready for in-engine implementation. And again, in closing, we'd just like to thank the judges and the community for all their support, and we hope to see you in the next phase of the competition. Thanks.
Yeah, my favorite ship, Shark Collective. Yeah, it's a perfect gunship design, but there are a few things I don't like. It's not much, but come to it later. The overall size of the ship matches perfect to the 300 series. What definitely not match is the size of the front landing gear. It's definitely too short. And of course the weapon holder on the front side looks cheap in my opinion. So I don't like this. It must be more integrated in the hull or something. Yeah, and the cockpit and the front shape reminds me definitely foreign Russian helicopter in the Soviet times, 80s and something. The Hind, NATO call name. But it's my point of the view. Maybe other people don't think like this. Yes, it's definitely a very, very good ship in overall, and the interior is fine, good and well designed. It needs a bit more deepness and something, but it's a competition. You cannot have everything ready and everything perfect. You have to find a good point, and they find the good point, the same as Four Horsemen.
Let's check out the next team, Shimapan.
Hey, it's Simon from Team Shimapan here, here to show off the latest iteration of our Drake Brutus gunship. Here's some our hit model in engine with some work in progress textures. Here you can see the engine with the side open, so you can see the interior that we modeled. And here's the beginnings of the interior of the drop pod without furniture, but we have those coming in from Maya pretty soon in the next few days. So here's some prelim models for, we also have those coming in soon from Maya. And let's show the opposite view with the, so you can see the other side with the cowling on, and here's some high poly renders for the stuff that we've been working on in Maya that haven't been baked yet. But you can expect them in the next few days for these to be baked and at least get some preliminary texture maps on them. So yeah, that's that, and here to show off some of the additional animations we've made. For basically on the non-game ready models. So here's a gray box actually for the new airlock for the squad deployment, and I think there's one more thing, and then the rest of it, and then let's go ahead and just draw some more detexturing and models. So thanks for watching. Goodbye.
Okay, let's come to the Shimapan ship. So this ship with the ugly duckling look is not my taste. I don't prefer that broken neck design. So the cockpit area reminds me more than a Apache gunship nowadays, so I don't like this concept. They work hard and they work good. They are very fine in details, but they put the most focus on the details, and that's not a good idea, because with this idea you don't win the competition. In my opinion, it's not a winner ship. So for aerodynamics, the broken neck design is not very realistic. So I don't like this concept. But the guys are very talented. So yeah, it's my opinion. Sorry. The Tngs are behind. They don't show interior stuff, so yeah, that's a big problem. Yeah, they are funny guys, I like them, but yeah, they are a bit behind, because I don't know. So yeah, keep on with the work, but I think it's a bit too less. So yeah, see what's coming up in the future.
So the last team to look at is Four Horsemen. Let's roll the video.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the Aegis Dynamics Redeemer Gunship. Please enjoy.
The Aegis Dynamics Redeemer-class gunship is the new top-of-the-line gunship, manufactured by Aegis Dynamics, designed specifically for piracy interdiction and police action. The Redeemer comes by default with two internally mounted Class 3 missile racks, two Class 5 gunner-operated turrets, and one Class 4-operated turret with two Class 1 hardpoints. The Redeemer gunship is designed to be operated by a crew of three, one pilot and two gunners, while still having space available for six Marines to engage in boarding action. The Redeemer is capable of holding a Class 5 power plant and a Class 5 shield generator, enabling it to bring sustained and heavy firepower into any encounter without sacrificing survivability. This gunship also sports a complement of 10 universal upgrade slots to allow any operator to customize his Redeemer to suit any mission-specific needs.
Whoa,
the marine compartment
nice
of the
interior.
Gunship comes equipped with six jump seats positioned alongside a boarding hatch. Here you will also find storage lockers equipped with space or combat armor for the Marine crew. The Redeemer comes equipped with small armory next to the belly turret gunner access port. The engineering compartment is equipped with Aegis Dynamics patented state-of-the-art force shield projectors and comes with high precision and high fidelity monitoring tools for optimal performance and in-combat tuning. The engineering compartment offers any engineer easy access to all the important gunship components, with the exception of the main engine nacelles, which are designed to be replaced completely within minutes at any well-equipped space dock. The living quarters come equipped with all the basic facilities a crew might need for extended deployments in deep space, such as fully equipped kitchen.
And the exterior.
I was about to say. The exterior is not bad,
but the interior is just like mind blowing.
There's a bed for every crew member, which also doubles.
It's all in engine. It's ready to go.
There's a coffee maker.
This is Disney.
The quarters also provide access to the top mounted crossbow turret. As you can see, the Aegis Dynamics Redeemer gunship is the next great starship to join the lines of the UEE in the battle against the Vanduul.
Yeah, that looks awesome.
Order your very own Redeemer gunship and become a horseman today.
Sean, Tracy, what about all the in-engine stuff?
Fantastic. Yeah, it looks like a final asset to me.
The interior is pretty amazing, I have to say. That's the best out of Griffmark. That's the best interior of any of the ones I've seen. I will say that I don't like the exterior as much as I like the interior, because there's something about the ship that just doesn't say sort of powerful gunship to me in the way that, say, a couple of the other designs have said.
Yeah.
I mean, I prefer the exterior of the Shard Collective ship. I prefer the exterior of the Talon one in terms of that sort of like kind of
beefy
sort of
gunship
vibe.
Right.
But
do you think there's anything that can be added that would?
It's weird because, you know, the modeling and the detail on it is all great. Same. So I'm not criticizing that. I mean, like, just in terms of modeling, detail, technical ability. I mean, yeah, absolutely. That's a AAA asset. There's no doubt that could sit in any AAA game. It could sit in Star Citizen. That's not the issue. It's really actually just a like a subjective
style
thing for me.
Sure.
And that was our last team. Okay, guys, so the voting process. Only two teams get to go through. What we're going to do is you're going to rank your teams, the five teams, from your most favorite to your least favorite. The most favorite will get 5 points, then 4 points, 3 points, 2 points, and 1 point. Okay. And then we'll tally up the points.
All right.
All right, let's get it happening. All right, guys, the votes are in. We used a point system, as you know, and here are the results. I can tell you this, 1-bit amoeba only got a total of 5 points. And 3 dingo, mi dispiace, arrivederci, they only had 12 points. Shard Collective had the most points of any of our 10 teams with 22 points.
Nice. Wow.
So congratulations, Shard Collective. All right, and then now,
so,
who is left?
Four horsemen or
Shimapan?
Exactly.
Shimapan
or four horsemen. One team had 17 points and one had 19. The team who is moving on. Who do you think? Chris, go on.
Oh,
four horsemen or Shimapan, quickly.
I think.
Too late, Christmas.
Shimapan.
I think four horsemen.
Oh, Lord.
Shimapan.
Four horsemen.
Jeez. And the winner is Shimapan. What? Shimapan's moving on.
Shit,
so 1-bit amoeba, 3 dingo, and 4 horsemen. It is not over for you guys. You go into the safe pool, and voting is open now. So go vote. All right, guys, so we're now entering the final phase, which is the in-game, in-engine implementation. And we will also find out next week the two teams who are saved. And Chris Smith will have an update on the Mustang. See you next Friday.
See you next Friday.
Later.
Bye. Holy shit, horsemen are in the safe zone. Oh, I can't believe it. I didn't expect that. So I'm pretty underwhelmed of this decision, because the ship has the best interior. The exterior and the shape are not my favorite, and with the nutcracker thing, I don't like the nutcracker engine. The design fits not For me, it's not aerodynamic, so I don't like this this position of the engine and the look. The rest is overwhelming. At this point of the competition, the most complete package.
Okay guys, which two teams did you save and put back into the competition? Let's find out. Well, you were the winner for the save vote.
Yeah. That's good to hear.
Yeah, you'll have to let your team members know.
I'll let them know right after.
So Paul, when you heard the feedback, how did you guys feel about that?
Well, we were watching the episode together in a group chat on Skype, and while we were still watching the second entry, someone else told me on Steam chat already that, oh, you've been put in the safe vote. And I just dismissed it as, oh, yeah, whatever. It's just that guy being that guy. And then other people started chiming in as well. I figured, oh, shit, we've been put in the safe vote. So we got to that part, and then it pretty much sunk in a little bit. And we were a little bit shocked, to be honest, I guess. But not depressed or something. I was like, oh, guess we'll have to just win the safe vote then.
And you did. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
The final six teams now, how do you feel?
We got some good feedback. And even, because we got put in the safe mode, we put some extra effort into, really bringing out the best that we could. And honestly, the ship's better for it. So we're pretty confident.
Very final vote on June 7 will be a community vote.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about that, rather than the judges voting?
Split. It really depends on who the two final teams are going to be. If we're going to be up against Shard or IXM, either way it's going to be a close vote. But I don't know. I honestly don't know. Looking at the reactions we've had on the forum so far, and obviously the outcome of the safe vote, I'm pretty sure we're almost equally as popular as IXM or Shard, for example. There's a lot of forum threads with polls, and it's all pretty close overall in every single one. So it's anyone's guess.
Who do you think the other save winner might be?
I'm hoping Cryo, because I was going to vote for Cryo myself, but then we got put in a safe vote as well, so voted for myself.
Of course. Okay, well, I look forward to seeing your ship. And best of luck for the final.
Thank you very much.
And I hope to see you in Los Angeles in 3 weeks.
I'm definitely looking forward to that, yeah.
All right, Paul. Cheers. Thank you.
Right. Have a great day.
You too. So how do you guys feel? You look well rested. You're all finished? Ship's ready?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you're working on Engine. Making other text, but we're working briefly on the engine to make a good presentation.
How did you feel about the judges' feedback?
I appreciate it because they told it's aggressive, and this is the idea I want the ship give, aggressive, like a monster coming and destroy all. This was the general idea, so yeah, I really love it what the judges say. I really appreciate too the frequency on the back, because there are too many things, and I have already removed it. I think I will make more around if I have the time. I don't know. I will try.
So you've adjusted it a little bit since being given the feedback? You've made some changes to the back?
Yeah. I always make changes for community, for the judges. I will try to to take all and make the bigger result as I can. But you know what we want to know.
Yeah. Well, congratulations, because you made the save vote.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we know Yeah, we was not sure. Until 42, we was sure we was out, so... Yeah, okay, yeah, I know.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
We have 6 teams left, but only one can win. And we want you to be there live for the finale on June 7th in Los Angeles. I have 30 free tickets left, and here's how this works. The first 15 people to tweet us at Robert Space End with the hashtag TNGS free tickets will win tickets for 2 to our live finale at the YouTube Space in LA. Tweet us starting now. Okay, this is it. Next week, the final round begins, and the judges will pick the first of the 2 finalists to be sent to LA. See you next Friday. Having said all that, are we ready to see the videos?
Let's do it.
Yeah. Totally,
let's
yeah.
Let's roll the video of Shimathan.
Hey, it's Adam from Team Shimathan here, and you can't tell that I am lifting, but yeah, I'm here to talk about the final presentation for our gunship. So, we've been a crazy week, and we basically pushed it as far as we could in this amount of time, so hopefully that you'll be able to enjoy that. We've also updated the design at some point, and I'm not sure what the last design that you guys saw was like, but this one's different. So, yeah, there's that, and there's also the orange, creepy, crazy cockpit that we decided to show you guys here. And we really tried to push the cockpit and all the other parts that are going to be next to, and the sensor module in the front, and the landing area, etc. So, yeah, so I really hope you like it. I sure as hell had a lot of fun making this, but yeah, I mean, we're not completely happy with it, so at some point we'd like to polish it regardless of what happens in the competition. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. Bye.
Looked like they needed to fix some of the time of day things. I saw that the cascaded shadow maps were all messed up. There was a big black square at one point. It was a little bit strange. The ship looks awesome. It looks great in engine, like I was saying. But again, it doesn't quite look metallic yet. It's really still very flat. So I would want to see a little more work on the materials. But it's a drastic improvement over the initial pass of the materials that we saw last week, I believe.
And I think that's what the next level for them would be. But, you know, I understand, you know, it looks great so far, you know, and it's just, if they, when they have a little more time, that's like the next step.
Plus on the cockpit, we have our HUD design system, you know, and I have to finagle that a little bit, you know, on their existing stuff, but, you know, that might change it up a little bit too. But yeah, you always want function to drive design.
Right? Absolutely.
So,
yeah. Think that's like an engineer.
That way it'll come off as realistic.
Right. But man, this ship is so close. I mean, it wouldn't take much to get into our game. A few loves here and there. It's cool. I love it.
Space is violent. Nature, chaotic. The man is wise to protect himself. Now is the time to let the fears of your ancestors be forgotten. Enact the predator. Become violence. Harness of chaos. Be the peacekeeper of your peoples, a harbinger of death to your enemies. Let them fear you from shadows. They give me many names, but I answer them one to one. I am the Aegis Shadow Mantis.
right, let's start with Chris Smith.
Oh. All right. There are some good things about this ship. I think the presentation is what hurt it the most. You know, it was hard to tell, and the renders that he had, it was sort of shrouded in darkness. Some of the shapes, you know, it looked like he modified the back with some more stabilizers and stuff, which wasn't necessarily bad, but it was just kind of hard to tell between his material setup. It was real shiny and real dark.
Previous episode, I don't know if that was the color, just because I sort of felt like the end started to get like spiky and mm-hmm. very bitty, and maybe that was sort of the red with the black, mm-hmm. and it sort of breaks it up even more. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I love the shape and the form of this ship. But I'm sort of talking from the previous time seeing it. So now in this, I just sort of don't really get a good read of that. And then it really hasn't stepped up and gone into the engine and really, you know, we said before, like the thing that's missing is the materials and the texturing.
All right, so let's check out Four Horsemen.
The Aegis Dynamics Redeemer gunship prototype has been improved since our initial unveiling. The cockpit has been redesigned with heavier armor, while minimizing visibility loss. The main hold has also been outfitted with additional protective plating. The main point of crew entry and egress is through the ship's rear access ramp. For docking and marine forced breaching, a boarding hatch is available as well. The Redeemer is an offensive weapon, designed and built for the purpose of putting ordnance on target and boots on the deck. By utilizing the ship's shape, turrets are positioned in a manner that allows gunners a wide area of converging forward fire, without sacrificing rearward coverage. A pilot utilizing the ship's stability and advanced control can easily bring down the largest of foes with a debilitating strike run. Through teamwork and focused damage, this gunship is in a league all of its own. Pilots of this gunship are afforded ample protection while retaining a wide view, ensuring a high level of situational awareness during combat. State-of-the-art control interfaces keep all ship functions within a moment's reach. The Redeemer's vector lock engines enable an unprecedented level of mass manipulation by moving the engine thrusters to optimal locations away from the ship's center of gravity, increasing overall stability, as well as combat maneuvers available to the pilot. Unlike multi-thruster casings or engines located within the hull, a nacelle-based system utilizes the exposed surface area to draw heat away from vital parts and into the environment, thus minimizing wear and increasing engine performance. The Redeemer comes outfitted with an onboard heavy-duty crane. Embedded in the tail, it is capable of lifting up to 20 tons. At 37 meters long, 19 meters wide, and 10 meters tall, the Redeemer is a robust combat package built on a versatile chassis. Mil-spec parameters were met without excess, keeping the overall signature to an absolute minimum. It has been said that innovation is not the result of chance. It is the result of action. We here at Aegis Dynamics 4 Horsemen Division take this to heart. When presented with the chance to design our military's next frontline ship, it was seen as an opportunity to advance beyond the status quo, to offer our skills and services for the betterment of mankind, and to deliver a combat-ready gunship that strikes fear and admiration into the enemy. This concludes our Aegis Dynamics Redeemer class update. And remember, become a horseman today.
We are going to do a live vote.
Dum, dum, dum.
Are you ready? Which side shall I start from?
You start.
The gold side.
Goldfinger over there.
Skeleton.
Shiny gold.
This is hard.
Who is your vote?
Because here's what my thinking is. Is that the Four Horsemen, I mean, those guys, obviously. So PBS is, so here's how it works. There's a Newton.
There's a Newton
Law of whatever.
There's this Newton guy.
Right. Mark, vote.
All right, okay, come on, what? Give us your vote.
I'm trying.
Explain. You okay?
I'm so like.
Nobody wants you to over-explain.
Right, because I like the design of the Shimapan ship. I like the ugly duckling broken head.
I'm shocked.
But obviously, the Four Horsemen ship is just, I mean, dude, top to bottom is like amazing. So just it's
pick,
like.
Pick with your heart, man.
So
pick with your heart.
Right in the middle.
He has no heart.
Pick with your cockles.
I'm gonna say the Shimapan.
No!
Oh, fire.
I know it's weird, but I love that like broken neck design. It just feels very like Russian gunship to me.
Okay.
The internet just gasped.
I know.
It just went.
The Four Horsemen, you know, they just had the most complete package at this point.
I am gonna get flamed so hard.
Yeah.
Oh my god, the Four
Horsemen. So your vote doesn't
like,
count, Chris.
It does not count. It does not count, but if I was voting, I would vote for the Four Horsemen because they are definitely the most complete package, the inside and the outside. It looks beautiful already in the engine. They're, of all the three ships we saw today, they're by far the furthest along.
Best texture.
Yeah, the texturing's fantastic. Yeah, I still have my issues with the outside. Love glancing.
I mean, once it was textured and with the glow, I actually liked it more.
I don't think they're as obvious now.
No, it's just they. But the Shimapan ship has a whole bunch of issues too because it's kind of ugly. But it's a nice engine implementation. But I just think that if I was going between them, I'd put Four Horsemen ahead of Shimapan, which, by the way, I actually did when they were up against each other last time. So. Not close. I thought they were very close, but same thing. So Four Horsemen. I'm glad they got saved by the community, and I think they absolutely deserve to go to the final.
Congratulations, Four Horsemen! Get your passports ready. We'll see you here live Saturday, June 7th, at the YouTube Space.
We're gonna meet them in person.
Yes.
Yay. Woo!
It's gonna be awesome.
They don't punch me.
They're coming all the way.
They may not want to talk to you.
Yeah,
they want to sit at your table, Mark.
So Shimapan and Talon, unfortunately. Your race ends here, but next week the community will be voting for third place, so you now go into the third place pool. So as you know, there are three teams left, and you can only choose one to go through. However, the save team, 3Dingo, were unable to make the deadline, which leaves us with...
Damn it.
Oh,
seriously?
What happened?
They were so excited, too.
Yeah, that's a lot. They were excited.
So, we only have the two teams to see today.
Wow.
For which you have to pick one. Two very
strong. I
guess
that makes it easier.
I guess it makes it easier a little bit. I'm disappointed.
It is kind of a bummer, because the 3Dingo design was fun, and they were fun, so maybe they just had too much fun celebrating the fact that they got saved.
Maybe.
Edgar 1, change optic to full screen mode. Two screens, please.
Introducing the scimitar, named after the feared ancient weapon. And pretty much as its name suggests, it will cut through your enemy lines. Its appearance will bring fear to those that oppose you. Its power will overwhelm even the toughest forces. Its multifunctionality will astonish your crewmen. This piece was forged at our finest Anvil Aerospace facilities. Kept under secret, for years during development and put through the hardest performance tests.
That's awesome.
You will find it.
I mean,
the
Merkin presentation, too. Others.
And now, on to the more technical presentation. As you will see, we've put a lot of work.
That's what basically a secondary version is surprising.
Yeah, it could be a primary one, though, too. Just a simple one.
Looks good. You need to move things around efficiently. Wheels are actually smart. Because if you're on a flight deck, you don't want to have to
roll
your thrusters to move 10 feet when you're rolling around.
We've improved all textures and shaders, since this was one of the main critiques in our last stage video. Like this, we can now also present different variations of the ship, may it be rescue operation or may even pirating.
We've also worked hard integrating our ship into the CryEngine, not just physicalizing all assets and integrating the animations, but also creating cool animations to show off the ship.
We believe most of you have already seen our last videos where we explained all the functionality of our ship in more detail, so this time we will just let the pictures speak for themselves.
It is. I think it's the spec. Like now that the light is hitting it directly, that spec is like really showing like the dark.
The lines. Because
they put a lot of lines in the spec, I think.
Look at
how
nice
big
here.
The dude is.
Oh, wow.
Like, how could that dude sit in that chair? There's no way.
We should have one of those.
One of them's got an arm.
All three of us would like to say a big thanks for all of your support on this journey till now. It's really meant a lot to us to see all your forum feedback and to hear from you your suggestions for the ship. And we'd also like to say a big thanks to CHG for hosting this competition and bringing us together to work on this project.
Yeah, I look at that ship and I go, yeah, I want that in my hangar. I want to, you know, I want to fly that ship and you know that shot walking up to it, where you could sort of, you were at, you know, your point of view.
Chills.
Yeah, you're like, okay, this is cool. So it is Shard. It's the Shard collective for me.
All right, Chris Smith.
Shard all the way for sure. I mean, best style so far on the exterior, I think. And yeah, I would like to really see them go head-to-head with Four Horsemen. Those are the best ships so far.
So, with Chris Oswald, this may make your couch irrelevant, but we'll just ask you anyway, so hold your horses. Okay? Chris O.
Horses. Four horses.
What do y'all think? No, I don't want to hear what you say. Let's make this couch irrelevant completely. I'm going with Shard all the way.
All right. Congratulations, Shard Collective. But before we okay, come
let's
on.
Let's talk to the relevant people.
Yes.
Does it matter, really?
Mark.
Does
it matter?
Say it at the same time.
Yeah, ready? One, two.
Oh, wait, we got to do this.
ready?
Remember?
He
one,
wasn't part
two,
of it.
Three.
I love
Shard.
You.
Shard. Oh, fuck. Wait, you missed it.
Oh, my gosh.
Shard. Yeah, Shard. We would. Well, I would have voted Shard. Absolutely.
Congratulations, Shard Collective. We will see you here live at the YouTube space on Saturday, June 7th. So get your passports ready, because I know all three of you are in different parts of the world.
It's going to be
so
exciting.
So give it up for Shard Collective.
So cool.
Come on.
Well done. Well done.
Very nice.
Rocked it, man. All that hard work paid off.
So Infinite Shui Monkey and 3 Dingo. Why not?
Sure.
Okay. Yep.
Go into the third place pool. So guys, get in there and vote for your third place getter.
Yeah, I have to vote for the ISM.
As you know by now, it's either Four Horsemen or Shard Collective who will have their spaceship put into Star Citizen.
Basically, we decided to design the Redeemer to be the Avengers' big brother, you know, to follow a similar design language, you know, nice curves, you know, all that stuff. And I hope that at the end of the video, you'll see what we had in mind while we were building this thing right from the beginning. So thanks to everyone who voted for us so far and who hopefully will continue to vote for us. We wouldn't have been here without you. Thanks. Enjoy the picture.
Hello, Star Citizen community. Over the course of the competition, we've been able to learn a lot, get an inside look at the inner workings of how ships work in Star Citizen, and overall just have a lot of fun. Though the competition hasn't been long enough to implement all the features we had originally hoped to, we're pretty happy with what we were able to accomplish and have been very impressed with what all the teams have been able to accomplish as well. But I think if nothing else, this contest has just really shown a passion within the community for the game we're all looking forward to and want to enjoy for years to come. grateful for the opportunity we had to make an impact on Star Citizen as a whole, and are even more grateful for the support and passion from the entire Star Citizen community. On behalf of our team, we'd like to thank the Next Great Starship production team, CIG, the fans, and especially the other contestants for putting so many hours in an effort to make Star Citizen a more engaging experience for us all to enjoy. Thanks.
Who do you want to win? Shard Collective or Four Horsemen? Let your voice be heard, because there will be a live vote for our winner during tomorrow's finale episode. Be there tomorrow, June 7th, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, to help determine the winner of the Next Great Starship.
Okay, for the TNGS finals, we make the last checks on the ship and then we try to start into the verse and leave the hangar for the first time. So let's do it.
After 4 months of grueling work, it all comes down to tonight. Welcome to the Next Great Starship. Hi, I'm Sandy Gardner, and this is the live finale of the Next Great Starship. Let's start. Let's start with the Four Horsemen video and how they got here.
We ended up with 10 thumbnails, and then we started cutting them up into pieces in Photoshop and basically sticking parts from one image into another. That way we created a horrible Frankenstein of thumbnail areas that we kind of liked.
It was tremendously helpful to receive feedback from the judges and other teams, and especially the community, and I think we realized what people liked about our concept and what they didn't like about it.
My new favorite. I actually really I don't know, I really liked it.
Design-wise, I thought it was pretty cool.
I like those big sort of, like, I think the thrusters or arms on the side.
Enjoying the work you guys have been doing, it's been really good. The most recent pass was actually pretty impressive.
So that was cool. I'm impressed. Loved it.
Chris Olivia.
I don't think the Vandal have fur. Do they?
I know, but you say furball no matter what.
It's a World War II term. Right. Okay. I'm sorry. I love the X-ray mode. That's what I thought you were going to talk about. Is the X-ray view is just really shows off the quality of the modeling in the interior. I love the heat refraction coming off the engines. It just gets me all excited. Yeah, watching that. color palette was beautiful. The presentation overall was nice. The shape language in this final sort of video. It just really shows off how sort of cohesive everything is as a design. So I'm just stunned and impressed to be in the presence of these people.
Let's see their final video.
After gathering as much information as possible, we proceeded with basic sketching and blockouts with various shapes and engine positions. I guess the hardest part was integrating the engines in this package and the space which it covers. Eventually, we noticed that the ship is too big, thus we had to rescale everything proportionately. This is our ship. I hope you guys like it.
I thought that was great. That was awesome. For me, this would be a gunship that, you know, I would be quite happily flying around and think would fit inside the universe really well.
I just thought proportionally and surface-wise, I thought they did an excellent job. It got me excited. I would want to fly around in this.
I liked it quite a bit, actually.
Yeah, I did too. It was really cool, man.
I thought it was beautiful. I really liked it.
more or less finalized the look and feel of our ship. Due to community feedback, we've decided to fix some additional problem areas: the turret's limited ability to engage targets on its tail, the off-centered placement of our main engines, and the aesthetics of the tail and the docking port of the ship. We dealt with the first two problems by lowering the placement of the engine nacelle connections.
Let's bring up the brains behind Shard Collective. Brian Cousins, Eric Andrew Belita,
great job,
and man. Sergio Stojkovic.
Great job, guys. What an overwhelming video. It's been a long road for you guys. It's been 20 long weeks of competition. You're here in LA. What's the experience been like for you so far?
I think partially it's just good to be here, good to see what, you know, Four Horsemen came up with and us. It's just been a good journey, you know?
The features, like modular stuff, like the cargo modular stuff and escape pods. We didn't get to show that. It's like so many features in the concept art that we just didn't have time.
When it came to the escape pod, where was that located and how does that function within the ship since we didn't get a chance to see it?
Okay, so the escape pods actually are the beds that the pilots and everyone else can sleep in. So they actually eject when the ship is in emergency situation. So yeah, it's really close to the pilot. So even if they're sleeping or something, you know, they get ejected automatically. So it's
and they're safe.
So they're safe.
No, that's great.
All right, everybody. This was a super close vote with 8 votes between Infinite Shui Monkey and 3 Dingo. And the winner of the 3rd place prize is 3 Dingo. Congratulations. They will all be celebrating in Italy tonight. We would like to bring up, excuse me.
Have you seen?
Let's bring the 2 teams up here, shall we? Let's get in a little closer, guys. Judges, you can sit down, please.
Oh, yeah.
All right, team. Burn. Team. Let's get a little closer. I don't bite. I'm sure. I swear I don't bite, David. Okay, let's remind everybody. Let's remind everybody what's at stake. Do we have Chelsea to show us the grand prize of $30,000? Here we go. And a bunch of cool swag, and of course, your ship in Star Citizen. And second prize is $10,000 and a bunch of cool swag. So, oh, okay. We crashed the site because there are so many votes. I've said that a couple of times. Okay, so do we
Star Citizen breaks the internet every time.
That's what we do.
Okay, we have a clear winner. I feel like a CNN reporter right now. The winner is, can I get a bit of a drum roll or clapping or something? The winner is 4 Horsemen. All right, Chris Roberts, let's have you present the check.
Congratulations to the Horsemen, and congratulations to the Shot Collective too, and of course to us all, because we all are winners. Fine ships created in this competition. Yeah, this is a very, very sad moment, because everything stops. The Tngs is over, and the Wingman's Hangar Show has his last episode too. It's 72 episode. What the heck is going on? I do hear a review, man. What do you do to my new ship? What the heck? I can't believe it, it's not possible what I see here. Oh god damn, the whole shit. My good ship, you Wendel scum, I hate you bastards. So okay, you guys make me freaking mad, so you pay the price for that shit you're doing to me, my ship. Okay, you assholes, throw the first stone, so I take this personally. I will shut down your freaky machine from this freaky place here. And that's the freaking shit you have to pay for, because you throw the first stone at me and I do nothing harm to you. And you will pay for that shit.
Initiated.
Ah, nice, I find the targeting system key. So you motherfucker, you fucked.
Stern shielding at half strength.
Warning, you are approaching the simulation boundary.
Refreshing shields.
It's only a matter of time till I rip your ass off.
Weil man die Straße nicht gepflastert hat. Kleinkrieger Flughafen, weil Tüpfigern sein langes Taxi nehmen. Sturmangriff in Herd, das ist doch nur der Einkauf wert. Panik in Grafenberg, es stahlen irren die Grünen im Gartenzwerg. Chaos am Stadtrand, doch nicht im Bild und deren Dorf. Die Lage ist ruhig an der Innenstadt. Front! Front! Mannal und Papis an Schall und Platz. Doch die Front, die hat sie satt. Keine Chance in neuen Babylon. Erzittern vor dem Aufschrei der Nation. Chaos im Stadtrand, doch nicht im Blick und Wärm. Doch die Lage ist ruhig an der Innenstadt. Front! Front!
Yeah, it's my first dogfight, but I love this freaking game. Please, more of them, more of them, more of them.
Alert. Systems overheating.
Yeah, there's the Wing Commander feeling coming up in me. Yeah, it's a very good, good game. It's definitely overwhelming. Yeah, you got it, pig face.
Scan initiated. Proximity alert. Proximity alert.
Yeah, don't mess with the Iron Club mercenary service, asshole. Whoa, you didn't see it coming. Yeah, nice shot. Okay, let me say something before we get shot down. To the steering of the ship is very nice. I played with my Mad Cat's Mouse Rat and keyboard, and it's yeah, the K-bindings are okay and I like it. It's smooth to play. Yeah, it's a bit at the beginning you have to check out the steering stuff and the laser stuff, and yeah, I don't know how to shot rockets, but I will learn it later in this fight. I will take the lasers only to train. Yeah, I like the idea from the Cloud Imperium games to let us play the Alpha and have a part of the establishment and see what's going on, what's happening on the game at this early stage. And I like it very much. Thank you for this. Oh, you make some mistake. Yeah, that hurts.
Proximity alert.
Shit! I see that coming. We got company.
Contact.
I have to find my way home. So I'm out of this shit here. So cannot fight with this Swiss cheese ship here. I like the 300 series. It's a very good ship. So I have to say goodbye, and I am out of this shit. And I hope I find the afterburner to get out of this here. It's time for an Immelmann maneuver. Holy moly, it's time to say goodbye. Guys, see you in the verse. Don't let the Vandals conquer the verse. Goodbye.